With the Omicron variant dramatically on the rise worldwide, Bay Area health experts warn it's only a matter of time before we see a surge in cases. KPIX5's Maria Cimedino with the warning from Bay Area health experts. Tonight, health experts predict a large wave of Omicron cases to hit California, but say it's up to us how damaging that wave will be. Some even urging us to rethink our holiday plans.
Want to make plans, but we're afraid to do something.
For the second holiday in a row, Deborah Leibovich and her family plan to spend it alone. This year, the more transmissible COVID variant known as Omicron is to blame.
We're just going to be by ourselves pretty much, you know, and just try and be real careful about not getting sick.
When I look around the corner ahead, what I see is a deluge of Omicron.
Today, Santa Clara County's public health officer, Dr. Sarah Cody, announced 10 new cases of the Omicron variant. And despite one of the highest vaccination rates in the country, the variant has now been detected in all of the county's sewer sheds.
What we think is going to happen is a big Omicron wave surge on top of Delta.
All of America should be concerned.
Stanford University Hospital epidemiologist Dr. Jorge Salinas says vaccines are no longer enough. Instead, layers of protection such as boosters, masks, testing, gathering in small groups and in ventilated areas should be seriously considered over the holidays.
Unless we make those modifications and potentially putting off travel if at all possible, January is going to look very bad for all of America.
Sad that we can't just move on, and there is no quick fix. I mean, we really have to sit buckle down.
According to health experts, the primary dose of the COVID vaccine is only 30% effective against the Omicron variant. It jumps to 70% if you're boosted, but begins to wane just 3 months later. In San Carlos, Maria Cimedino, KPIX 5.
The Omicron variant has prompted Stanford University to move all classes online for the first 2 weeks of winter quarter. The school says that it hasn't seen an increase in cases so far, but the administration isn't taking any chances, with many students traveling during winter break.